Hi everybody, welcome to Crossways. I don't know if you've been, some of them been here before, or is it all first time?
First time.
Okay. A lot of people say, what is this? Why here? I can now say, because it's been proclaimed as the first new town in Coga, or in the Eastern Cape, for many years. 53% of our population lives in rural South Africa, and very little is happening in rural South Africa to create opportunities for the people living in rural South Africa to participate in the economy. So food security, rural development, job creation, national strategy, poverty alleviation, national strategy, training, national strategy. Through the site analysis and through the planning, and one third basically is conservation, either steep slopes or sensitive vegetation or conservation worthy vegetation. So one third, all these dark green areas, even through the bridge there, up in that area, the Verstappen's Wildflower Reserve moves in there. So one third is conservation, one third agriculture, and one third development. Development consists of mostly residential, our own school, sports fields, and the town center. It's like a village town center. It'll be a small town center. So you have a smart farm water meter. You get farm water piped to your development, because it's cheaper to irrigate with farm water than to irrigate with potable water. So there's a lot of sustainability thinking behind it. And then we've got potable water, we've got a fiber connection, we've got an electrical connection, and you get a sewer connection. It also means that the minimum requirements in terms of hot water heating, a solar hot water heating, you've got to have solar hot water heating, you've got to have rainwater harvesting. And the house that you will see that here is going to take you to is fully off the grid. It's the ultimate. The show house that you will see is the minimum requirement. And then you can add on, as your budget grows, you can add on your roof, solar and battery and power will become more off the grid if your budget allows. The show house that you will see, you must listen carefully, because you're going to form an immediate vision in your head. If I tell you that the show house that you will see, the stand size is 50 to 60 square meters smaller than an RDP stand. The result is because the entire big street running there is totally free from garages, entry roads, parking areas, or cars parked and blocking up the front space of a driveway. There are no driveways. Everybody comes in from the back. It's pedestrian friendly. The footpaths are not in yet, but you go there, you go to the castle, step outside in front of that castle door, will be a 2 meter wide, compacted gravel, nicely smooth walkway. Houses are going to get smaller, plots are going to get smaller, people are going to keep on living in smaller and smaller and smaller houses, and that's why we respond to that, by providing smaller houses. Apart from the cows and the butter and the cheese and the milk and the yogurt, we want to put in fruit trees, and we bring in various fruit trees and the gardens and the orchards, and the idea is that people start participating and producing what we call the edible landscape. Refuse removal system, local contractors, local people. Because it's so high tech, it will be the first place in South Africa where we force people to have a full bag garbage system. Plastic, glass, organics, and hard stuff. Only the hard stuff will go to the waste side, the rest will get recycled here. You put a barcode on your garbage bag, you force the people to separate that source. So that's the basis behind this whole philosophy of what you see here. Sustainability, rural development, job training, creation, job creation, poverty alleviation, and creating people into the economy. Apart from the people who are going to build here and live here.